talking with Dr. Alveda King. Excited to talk to her, and we're going to talk about being thankful in a thankless world. And Alveda, first off, thank you so much for your time.
I'm so glad to join you, your viewers, and your listeners, and to just say God bless everybody.
And Alveda, in the times that we live in, I mean, where are you, where do you pull the thankfulness? I mean, it's got to be inside, doesn't it, to begin with?
Well, it's good to find something every day that we can appreciate, even in the darkest times. My grandfather, Reverend Martin Luther King Sr., of course, lost two sons in the civil rights movement. My uncle, Martin Luther King Jr., Uncle Emil, was shot in 68. My dad, Reverend Alfred Daniel Williams King, was killed in 1969. And then in 1974, Granddaddy's wife, Alberta King, was shot playing the organ at Ebenezer Baptist Church. And my grandfather said something that was just amazing to me, but it remains in my heart today. Thank God for what we have left. And almost everyone can do that. Even if you read the story of Helen Keller, for example, severely disabled, but able to make contributions anyway. So I do that. Sometimes it's not easy because life right now is very difficult with COVID and race wars and CRT arguments and all of that. And so God reminds me, fear not, don't fight each other, fight to live.
And I know, Dr. King, you were just announced as chairman for the Center of the American Dream. And how much does the thankfulness play into that and being a part of something that your family has been and striven to move forward over the years?
The American Dream is rooted in the words, in God we trust, in one nation under God. So at the Center for American Dream, we deal with human dignity, with civil rights, of course, and all of the other issues that affect us as Americans. And it just says not America only, just America first. And with that is one nation under God. And so if we begin to embrace our lives here in America with that perspective, it's easier even to find things to be thankful for. For instance, my wonderful assistant, executive assistant, Eugene V. Hill, died of COVID not long ago. My friend Herman Cain died of COVID. My friend Harry Jackson, those were mentors and friends and people that I worked very closely with. And I was like, okay, Granddaddy, what do I have left? He said, you have a mission. You have God first. You still have God and you have a mission. And there are many other things that I could mention that I have left. And I think each and every one of us, especially if we've been impacted by COVID, and almost everybody has, either you've had it or argued with somebody about taking a shot or not taking a shot. But don't argue with each other. Just fight to live and fight to be kind and to repent.
And Dr. King, what can we learn from what has happened these last 2 years? And how can we mend those fences that unfortunately we've let emotions build up even stronger strongholds than we've had before?
If we can remember, we are one human race. Acts 17:26, of one blood, God made all people, all flesh came from one blood. So we are one human race. My uncle, Martin Luther King Jr., said we must learn to live together as brothers. He didn't say neighbors or kinsmen or cousins, but brothers and sisters. I added sisters. So the skin color issue, we are one blood. Now people say Black lives matter. Black lives matter because all lives matter. Black people are human beings. So put it in context to every life matters and that God's love matters. Is there a critical race? Absolutely. The human race, the one blood human race is the critical race. So if we can get those perspectives and stop fighting, and we're not colorblind. We can actually see each other. We can see ethnicity and we can celebrate ethnicity. Jesus gives sight to the blind. So we can't go around saying I'm blind. I can't see. And so I have to remind people of that all the time.
And what are the main tenets of the Centers of the American Dream? What are the main tenets and the as you move forward into a new year as well?
Center for the American Dream deals with human dignity from the womb to the tomb. We want our babies to all be born. We want them to be born into safe and secure places in society. So we have to work with all the other centers. We work with every center, whether it's education, justice, the area that gives you the second chance when you come out of prison, finances, medicine, safety and security. I can't name all the centers, there are several, but each one is important. So like the importance of life from the womb to the tomb, human dignity for every American, regardless of any circumstances. And so we're going to be traveling around the country to colleges with panels and talks and that kind of thing. We're going to develop the website pretty well so that people can weigh in and add their testimonies and let us know what's happening in their communities.
And Dr. King, I know where the dream ends, but what kind of advancements are we making? Too many times we focus on what we don't have, but talk about some of the advancements that you have been able to see.
Well, I'm 70 plus years old now, and I lived in a time where you had to drink out of colored water fountains and white water fountains. You couldn't go to a movie theater. If you did, you'd have to have some sequestered, so some secluded seat or something. You couldn't try on clothes when you went to shop. All of those kinds of things did happen in my early lifetime, and none of that exists today. Justice has been kind of slow in some cases, but the young men in Alabama, I believe, that were accused of raping a lady and all these years later have been exonerated through DNA testing. And what we're seeing, I was in D.C. this week, and with the Dobbs case, deciding whether or not to send the question of abortion back to the states and let the people weigh in with their votes and those kinds of things. So I have seen a remarkable difference. And young people, you know, little kids don't even necessarily know that. I've had little children come up to me and rub my skin to see why I was different from theirs and that kind of thing. But kids don't discriminate that way. My mother says hate has to be taught.
Yes.
And so we will love each other and get along if we work on it.
That is right. Well, Dr. King, I want to make sure and let our listeners, if they would like to find out more information about the Center for the American Dream and any of the other works that you've got going, I want to make sure that we direct them to find more information.
Well, if you will just put the AFPI, American Center, not for the American Dream, I'm sorry, America First Policy Institute. And once you get to America First Policy Institute, you can scroll down and find me also at alvedaking.com and Speak for Life.
Well, Dr. Alveda King, it has truly been a privilege. I appreciate carving some time out, pulled off to the side of the road to share some one-on-one time with us today.
And Merry Christmas, everybody. Yes.